I was wondering this morning if you're sleeping in my bed.
Pardon?
You see, I believe you are. We rented Mr. Brown's half the house this summer while you were journeying in Scotland. Which room do you sleep in?
The one overlooking the back garden.
That was my bed. For proof, pull it from the wall and by the pillow you'll find a figure I drew with pinholes.
Is the figure you?
It's a fairy princess.
Should I be feeding her?
She refuses to eat. Would you teach me poetry? I'd like to understand. I don't know how to begin.
Abbie Cornish, the new exciting bright star, I came as the title role here, the bright star.
Yeah, you did. You definitely got a bit of glow going on there.
Thank you, so do you, dear. It's called Oscar Gold in your future, I think, an Oscar nomination for your performance in Bright Star. Darling, what a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you. Cheers.
You're so beautiful. Oh, my God.
Thanks.
So tell us about Fanny. I mean, what a role, my God. Mm.
Yeah, incredible role. I mean, there was so much to dive into, so much to explore, so much to kind of find out about her and about myself. It was really fun.
And she's a fashion. She was like almost started mm-hmm. women's fashions almost single-handedly in terms of being her own designer and wearing her own clothes.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. She loved it. I think for her that was her, you know, avenue to express herself, you know, to show her personality, show who she was. I think she, you know, kind of an artist in her own right, you know, and I think that's why she really loved Keats's poetry and his, you know, passion for the creative world as well.
So I didn't know up until I just read the production notes that you were Australian. So I know you from the wonderful Elizabeth movie in which you were stunning, and
thanks.
I predicted an Oscar nomination then too, but so how did you get from Australia into Bright Star, which of course is made in Australia, so that makes
it was
sense.
Made in, it was actually, we shot the film in London actually.
Oh.
Yeah, and it was an English-Australian co-production, but I auditioned in Australia, yeah.
So was there a lot of auditions? Did you have to convince Jane? Was it
just one audition? I was the first person that she did audition, and you know I felt pretty confident about this film and this role. You know, sometimes things come along and you just feel like you have to do it. You feel this certain pull and a connection, and you know if you're lucky enough that comes to fruition.
What do you think that pull was? What do you think the identification with this character was for you?
I just adored her. I just fell in love with her, you know, and just the what she goes through and just her dedication to Keats and to their love and just the love that they have to between each other and the purity of it and, you know.
And she's a caregiver. She takes care of his brother first, right, as well as him.
And yeah, and she's just an interesting person too, you know, because she's
you
know, she's strong and confident, but at the same time delicate and sensitive. You know, she can be loud and other times quiet. There's just such a huge range of personality traits to explore.
Well, a role with a range like this, the title role of Bright Star, Abbie Cornish, A Thing of Beauty is a Joy Forever, as are you, my dear.
Thank you.
What a lovely morning at the Toronto Film Festival. We have to keep saying where we...
Yay!
Okay.
Thank
Congratulations,
you.
Congratulations, darling.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Yeah, have a good day.